Happening, man.
Yo baby, what's up? How you doing, babe?
So yo, what's up? What did you do when you woke up this morning?
I don't know, I rolled over, you know, rolled her over and slapped it a couple times.
Yo, what'd you catch on the tube today so far?
Oh man, this morning, man, I was rocking the Serious Man from U.N.C.L.E., original Black and White, episode number 23, I believe, with guest starring Ilsa Lancaster. Remember the Bride of Frankenstein? She had the same hairdo. It was excellent, dude, excellent.
I hear that. Have you caught any episodes of The Fugitive lately?
Yeah, I like that. Dr. Richard Kimball, wrongly accused for the murder of his wife.
Dude, a Quinn Martin production.
My man. That's my man, man.
So tell me, Dr. Revolt.
Yes, Rappin' Ripicky.
Legend of graffiti, if I may.
You may.
Add that to you. You were so, how do you say, prolific in the early 80s with the graffiti movement. You know, what's transpired over the 80s into the 90s?
90s, oh shit, I don't know. Graffiti's dead. Long live art.
I hear you. I don't get to be in Rolling Stone every week, but, you know, catch me while I'm in my 15 minutes of fame this week. And, you know.
It's still there. Yeah.
I'm going to savor every second of the 15 minutes, believe me.
Pairing him with Merv Griffin.
Welcome today. We're in the palace of the rap Svengali, Mr. Russell Simmons.
Palace.
How are you, bud?
Cold, Mickey.
Chilling?
It's a palace, like that?
Yeah. I love the way you've, you know, dressed for today's interview.
Jim, I didn't dress for your interview, Ricky. Sorry.
That's okay. You're looking good. You've been working out?
Long time, Ricky. Every day, man. I'm trying to fix myself.
I heard you've been working out.
On your collar, man.
Marlon Brando.
That's ridiculous. He's
what?
I watch Rix's show regularly. He's known Rix is ridiculous. I've known Rix for a lot of years. I remember when Rix used to go on the road and pick up any group, but now the age is... Now the age is spreading. He's calmed down some. But he went on a Beastie tour. Beastie Boy tour, slept with every girl he could find. It's ridiculous. He used to go tongue darts, he used to talk about. We used to laugh at him all the time.
Oh, stop now.
He was the comedian of the tour.
Yo, what's up, my mellow? How you been?
Yeah, I only know I'm getting paid for this.
What? Dude, I think I got 2 cents.
2 cents? But what's the shoot here?
You're on the show Rapping with the Rickster.
Rapping with the who?
Yo, man, you dissing? Yo, Rapping with the Rickster.
And who's the Rickster?
That's me, dude.
Oh, you rapping now?
Dude, man.
You got any records out?
No, we're just rapping. We're rapping. We're relating.
Oh, we're relating. Is the cops out here?
Right there, G. You got any good smoke? No.
You want to buy some?
Yeah, actually, we're looking to buy some good dust.
Oh, shit. There we go. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Oh, snap.
The king. Chris Walken, right. Yeah.
That's
Christopher Walken.
Chris Walken, not Chris as in KRS-One.
No, not Chris as in KRS-One, but Chris Walken, you know. Deer Hunter, you know, at close range, like that.
Mr. Dusted.
Yeah, that's him. The Edge. I like to say that Chris Walken is the Edge.
I hear you, man. I smoked some good hash with him one night.
Did you?
Yeah, it was rocking.
No shit.
Yeah, from Lebanon.
All right, cool.
So, I don't know. Tell me, man, do you own a Farfignugan?
A Farfignugan? No, but I have experienced the Farfignugan driving experience when I was in Los Angeles. I have a friend who owns one of those Jettas. And so I've had the opportunity to experience Farfignugan several times.
Farfignugan.
Farfignugan. Yeah, that's it.
Uh-huh. And how's your game on the basketball courts these days?
Well, I have to confess my mellow. The Fishman is not the biggest sports fan in the world.
Really?
Really. Actually, my favorite pastime is you know, kind of like messing with sports fans, friends of mine. You know, as for instance, like when the Boston Red Sox or whatever that Boston team is, they were in a World Series or something.
Uh-huh.
They were playing the Mets. I walk up behind, you know, Mets fans and say things like, Bo Sox in four, you know.
Oh, my God. That's a good way to risk your life.
Yeah.
God dang.
But, you know, I can hang. I mean, I can fake it now. You know.
I'm sure, because, I don't know.
My jumper looks good.
Yeah.
You know, I look good coming up off the floor, but as far as, you know, hitting anything and really taking anything to the hoop, nah.
Well, that's all that counts, that it looks good.
Exactly. You know, after all, it's, you know, filmmaking is a visual thing.
This is a beautiful Doberman. Come here, baby.
I signed a contract.
Come here. What's up? What's up, baby? Yeah. Can you get that? What a cool dog. This is what my son would look like. What's up? What's up? Damn, I just went through traffic, man. It was pretty rough. But speaking of traffic, man, you ever, like, when you're walking up the steps in the train station after you get off your train, you're walking up the steps, you got your face in someone else's behind area, but you ever think that someone else has got theirs and yours? I mean, do you ever think about that? But anyway, enough of this. I don't know. Today, man, if I got guests for you, man, I got guests, funky people. And, well, let's get right to it. My first guest is a chick or a young pretty lady. How are you? This is Sharon Mittendorf.
Hi.
How are you?
I'm good. How are you?
Good. Illing. Thank you.
Yo, what's up? This looks good.
What are you getting into? Oh, thanks.
Mm-hmm.
Stop.
Mm-hmm.
So you're looking good. What are you doing? What are you doing yourself these days?
Well, playing a lot of music.
This girl was the girl in the Beastie Boys' first video. She's on it. This is the girl whose legs you saw. And
these are the legs.
God bless your parents.
Uh-huh. Come on.
So,
Yeah, I did that, but I decided that I don't want to be in someone else's videos anymore.
You're going for yours.
That's right, yeah.
Why? You may not put that on film.
No, I'm just kidding.
I'm kidding to beat you up.
Yeah, that was on film.
Don't do it. Oh, what did you guys say about his culture?
It's real.
It's real. You licked ass in front of the group.
You know that.
You ran across the stage naked. Right. We have pictures
on,
of you naked
and
on the stage.
Girl. Oh, yeah.
We have pictures of you, and London has the whole pictures of you naked with
all videotapes. Oh, yeah.
Often naked.
On the cover of newspaper in London.
And silly as your hair do it. I think your hair do is fucked up.
Ricky.
He's worse than BST for 3 times dope.
Oh, come on.
Why is that?
Yeah, shit. He got it all cut over the side. He got the fucking Adam Harvick in the front.
Dude, how about you? You have the MC Milk look.
What does Milk look like? I saw Milk's new video. He was so dope.
He
What's
is.
That?
He's the deafest
junior. Fuck all
the others. He says you got the MC Milk look. That's how MC Milk looks. That's my shade of baseball cap. Yeah.
Fuck y'all. All of you.
Dude, yo, what's up with his video?
He better do it now, because after Ricky finishes his pictures, I'm walking.
No, I'm saying Milk's video.
Hey, how are you?
So listen, man.
What?
We had good times in Amsterdam, right?
Yeah.
Miss? I have to refill. Dude, what's up? I'm just doing a photo shoot with Run-DMC.
I'm on TV.
And this is what it's always like. I don't know, man. It just, like, reminds me of the movie I want to do. I just want to say, just natural, baby. Just natural, baby. But which reminds me, oh, what's up, guys? I'm sorry. Wait, let me take a photograph. Guys, can you zoom in here? Oh, tremendous.
Peeping out the window.
What's up, man?
Peeping out the window, checking on the criminal.
You just happen to have your cameraman around.
That's that. That's
what
that.
A coincidence.
That means you're large. You're large.
All right, so.
Shabba Ranks. Shabba Ranks.
Oh my.
Girl, you a dream about me all the time. That's why I got to call him on the telephone line. Me gonna step on me mino, step on me mino, step on me, step on me, step on me, step on me mino. How's the bun, the girl, I'll take a telephone line. He's too deaf.
Oh my God. What is that? Shabba, new stuff?
Incredible. It's not new.
Oh.
It's just incredible class. Shabba Ranks that we appreciate.
I hear you. So I hear that, Daryl, you are running kickbacks back for the Giants.
Yeah.
Yes.
Uh-huh. Cool. Jay.
He bit out his.
You're.
Nah, I'm the new cheerleader.
Yes, yes.
Oh,
yes.
Oh, shoot.
Bozak and
Corporate. Well, come over here, man. I want to get the nice sundown.
Come
it's
on.
Nice. Dude. It's aesthetic.
Hey.
Do y'all go to school out here?
No, we don't go to school. Just work.
Do y'all work out here?
Close enough.
Huh?
Close enough. I just came out here to catch my check and say.
I just want to say this is the highest honor of
Thank
flattery
you.
Right here.
Okay, bye-bye.
When you appear on the cover of Mad Magazine.
Yeah,
it is.
Gentlemen.
All right. What's up, my party people? We're here for another episode premiering the 1990s version of Mod Squad. We got Lincoln Hayes, Pete, and the new Julie. Now, actually, I'm just pulling a fast one on you. This is...
What's your name, sir? Well, I know it's a trick question.
Why don't you tell him?
Wait, we have here Gregory Abbott.
You read my mind. Let me see that. Come on.
This is Shay Adams, the art director of the universe.
What's up?
And over
Gregory,
here have...
Gregory, he it's Adam.
Adam Horovitz, the famous actor.
Ione.
Ione Skye, the famous actress. I only have famous people on my show. Can you pan over there? I used to play basketball in that park with Hawthorne Wingo in like 1973.
Squiddy's over there.
Where?
No, I'm just kidding.
Yeah, it's only bums now. So, we are, you know, Nikki. So anyway, you guys are visiting from Los Angeles. What's happening with you guys?
In life, visiting here in New York.
Yeah, you know, what's happening?
I thought you said this is an action adventure show.
Dude, you're supposed to be naked. Shut up. What's going on? What's going on in this first week of November of 90 in this beautiful day? What's going on?
Wow. Five buddies.
It's a beautiful day, man.
Stop dissing me. I'm the host.
You,
yeah,
man.
Yeah.
It's a beautiful day today, man.
Yes.
It's been a beautiful
They all
time.
Are friends for a very long time, the three of these
the
knuckleheads.
Consultant.
Yeah.
And you're our new friend.
I'm the new friend.
A beautiful addition to the posse.
I balance it out.
Right.
Just say for us once, this is our posse.
Go like this, say, pick up the phone and go, hello?
No, this isn't right, man. We need the captain here. This is not.
Nice. All
right, dude, so anyway, tell me, while you're in New York, what have you been doing here?
Walking, man, walking. It's been beautiful.
Buying records.
Mm-hmm. Buying records. Damn, they had James Brown Superbad for $60 at the store.
Those products, you know, on the
Oh,
shop.
That's right. But it's been a great time. Ooh! Those guys are standing right there. They're going to get hit by the car.
What happened? Another bike mess?
Do you remember we were walking when you lived on 2nd Avenue and that guy fell down in the middle of the street?
Is it all right if I mention Eric's having a birthday?
That's nice.
Yeah.
Well, actually, no, you are too. That's right.
Yeah.
Ricky's got a birthday coming up soon.
Yeah.
One day before my kid Eric, right?
I'll be 29 on November 20th.
Eric will be 29.
You're getting old.
So don't fuck around.
Ricky's got a really weak layup, and he's definitely not strong going to the boards.
Dude, you've never beaten me in one-on-one in basketball. When? Did I beat you for your house?
13th Street. 13th Street?
You already owe me a house.
Let's see if somebody's over.
Dude, you can't even afford 25 cents. Oh shit, we're getting, what the hell's going on here?
I'm getting a tan right now.
All right, that's great.
Oh man, you're so broke you can't pay attention.
Dude, they're gonna deliver 1,000 calculators now.
You're so ethnic looking. You used to get marked, used to get marked absent in night school.
Yo, man, I'm gonna get Mike Tyson on you again.
What's up? What are you doing here?
I'm getting my hair cut.
What is this style called, sir?
That he has right now.
Right now, he's got a scissor. Styling, yes.
Not scissors. The
not scissor, right, yeah.
It was a Caesar.
Right,
now
we're trying
to
get all this here, blend it in with this one in the front there.
Yeah. Uh-huh. Interesting technique. So anyway, Ione, how are you doing?
Good, just got a good trim from Tony over there.
I see, it's beautiful.
A little trim.
Beautiful.
Yeah. Did you get it?
Beautiful, beautiful.
Got some of the split ends off.
Beautiful. So tell me, how's it, you know, tell me, anything on your mind?
Anything on my mind?
What were you doing in New York this week?
I was working.
Care to mention what?
Yeah, I was doing a play, Adam's dad's play, called, it's called The Sugar Plum.
I'll tell you, man, that's the life.
Yeah, it's a good life.
Yeah? Oh, shut up. So, how's your love life?
Very nice, very comfortable, full of love.
Ah, that's great.
Yeah.
And you're on a special diet now?
Well, I just stopped eating dairy. Mm-hmm. I had already been a vegetarian since I was 15. And now I just stopped dairy because I read that book, Diet for a New America. And so after reading that, I couldn't bear the thought of being a part of the horror.
I hear you, man.
Yeah,
I
no, you're inspiring. You are good. You're good with your food.
Okay, we're activists for animals, and on one of the coldest and snowiest days of the year, we're going to take off our clothes, go behind a banner, and tell the public that we'd rather go naked than wear fur.
I've been on here for a while.
No banners.
Well said.
Yeah, exactly. We're freezing.
Shame.
We're freezing, but
shame. Shame.
We
shame.
Can't show people
shame.
That
shame.
Fur
shame.
Is dead.
Shame. Shame. Shame.
Straighten it up.
You ladies are very courageous.
Use your head. Fur is dead.
All right, ladies, what's up? Come here. I want to ask. What are you getting into? What are you getting into here? What are, tell
am
me,
I
talk
getting
to
into?
Me. I want to ask you some cultural questions.
Okay. What am I getting into? What do you mean?
Were you girls shopping or what?
Oh yeah, I bought a jacket. Sorry.
Cool. Where are you from?
Brooklyn.
Really? What part?
Carroll Gardens, near Park Slope and Brooklyn.
I've heard it by the F train.
Right.
And what school do you go to?
Dewey. High school.
High school? I thought you were in college.
Sorry.
All right, so you're on the show Rapping with the Rickster.
I'm sure.
What? Yo, why do I keep getting dissed?
Oh, yeah, like you're being dissed. Nice
I'm
shoes.
Just kidding.
Green.
Thank you. I know, nobody else has these. So what grade are you in?
Senior. Senior.
Really? What are you doing next year?
I'm hanging out for a year, and then I'm going to college.
Really?
Yeah.
What school?
I want to go to Purchase.
SUNY?
SUNY. Yeah, they're cheaper, man.
That's cool. All right, well, what are your names?
I'm Sarah.
Cool.
Nicole.
Cool. You have nice eyebrows.
I told her that.
Or which is the one on top, brows or eyelashes?
Both brows.
Okay. You have You're gonna go far with those lashes. I mean, those brows. All right, girls. Have you ever heard of me?
No, sorry.
Yeah, actually, you have.
Uh-oh, dissing. They're on the Disnick. All right, ladies, thanks for chatting. And look for us on Tuesdays at noon on 17 and Thursdays at 2 p.m. on 16. But that's on Manhattan Cable. I don't know how you have it in Brooklyn.
I don't know, man. People are fucking weird these days.
Oh, all right. That's kind of wild, yo. That's kind of bug.
All right, let me ask you this. Can I ask with the graffiti tip? Can you reveal what you used to write?
I used to write Crane, RTW, the Fresh Kids, you know, wow, RTWCR, TNS, you know, rolling back the days, the original, Rolling Thunder Writers, you know.
Ah, damn, you guys were like the shit. You guys and the Rebels at one time with the...
We was ruling, we was kings of the lines.
I used to go to Hunter College and I used to take the 6 train to school, every morning, Cranes, CR, all over the 6
trains. All over the trains, you know, trying to blow up, you know.
You did damage, boy.
Did damage. I hope the 50 don't come and get me now. You know, it's too late, it's over with.
Dude.
You know, never been caught. Yo, you know, I seem like the graffiti scene is starting to come back a little bit now.
Yeah?
I just did this TV Guide commercial, too. I want y'all to know. It should be coming out soon.
Yeah?
So, you know, just finished it. And I'm rapping. I did all the music.
Really?
Yeah, you know.
It's a bad time, yo. I want you, out of most everybody, to, like, get paid in 91.
Dude. Yeah, that's true. You know, there's money out there to be made. Entrepreneurs. Dude,
how's your love life?
My love life, you know, look at me. I look good, you know, it's great.
Yeah?
You know, it's lovely.
You want to say hi to your lady?
Yeah, how you doing? You know who you are. How you doing? You know what I'm saying?
Shit.
I want to say hi, you know.
All right,
to the special
cool
one. She know how she look with the pretty, nice, nice eyes, pretty skin, nice like my height, looking good.
She's fine. I used to see her on the 14th Street Questdown bus.
Yeah, she looked good.
Right, she told you, right?
Right, she told me. She told me.
I should give her much respect.
All right, right.
Hello, Mrs. Crane.
Yeah.
How's your mom?
She's nice. She's chilling, you know.
She's always really nice to me on the phone when I call your house.
Oh, you know, it's the upbringing.
Yo, you guys are cool. Right here, yo. All right, you ready? Okay. Yo, yo. What's up? What's up, yo? I got some shit for you this week, boy. Yo, man. I got these guys. They are called Cypress Hill. This is the Cypress Hill. The shit that is gonna hit the storm this Christmas. This is.
Yo, this is Be Real. You know the Buddha one.
Uh huh.
And I'm Send Dog right here, Papa the Tribe.
Ah, cool, cool. You guys, man, just come out of nowhere with some shit, man. You know, like, if I was on American Bandstand and they played it, I would say, it has a funky beat and I could bug out to it. That's what I would say. But, uh-oh.
Could you do that shit? Could he do that?
Fuck it. I don't care. Fuck it. Well, tell me, man, what is, you know, tell me what's up with your music? What's up? What are you guys about, you know?
Well, basically, our music is bold, blunted funk. What we do is we get a bit of the old school style flavor. You know, basically we get the music from the old school, put it in a new school form, mm-hmm. with our ideas and concepts, like what we see on the street and all our experiences that we've had on the hill.
Where's the hill?
That's in California, in Southgate, street in Southgate, California,
uh-huh.
where we all stay and get blunted. Uh-huh. But, you know, when we mix the old school flavors with the new school flavors in our hip hop format that we, you know, we put break down to a science, we also get blunted.
Uh-huh, uh-huh.
And then, you know, then out comes the blunted funk.
Uh-huh. Any comment on that? Hey, you guys want to rock some shades?
A little too futuristic for me, man.
This is really not my color anymore, man.
Well, you have voices that really complement each other, you know? Kind of like, I'm not saying you're them, but, you know, the same kind of chemistry that Flavor and Chuck D have. You have,
well,
and that Run DMC had, too.
Yeah, well, you know, we've been told that a couple of times, but,
yeah?
You know, we like to go against the grain and disagree that our style is like anybody else's.
Okay.
You know, like B-Real, he kicks the nasal style. And on the tape, you also hear this voice that's my regular voice. Mm-hmm. And I also got like a much deeper voice, mm-hmm. that we call it the beta voice.
Yeah.
And it's simply like, oh, I could just kill a man. Just kill a man.
That's when he turns to Psycho Beta Sen, y'all.
Oh, see? My God.
When he turns to Psycho Beta, forget about it, because then he's the beta master.
Well, I could tell you one of those dudes in junior high school that could do a million sit-ups.
People need to, you know more than it's just good to get you high. It's not just the fact of the high that we're trying to stress. It's, you know, a lot of other things that it's good for. I mean, you didn't catch all that on this first album, but on the next one,
oh,
you'll
really?
Catch all of that.
Yeah, I gotta tell you, man, side one of the album just fucks me up.
Well, you know, everybody's gone through the school of hard knocks, man. And when you go through that school, you're bound to catch up with the police, or the police is bound to catch up with you.
I hear you. You know. So Mike D is our guest filmmaker today on the back of the bike, so we'll see what's up.
My hands aren't very steady, though. I had years of abuse, so shit isn't too straight.
Yeah, buddy!
Wow, kid, I have to do some business with you.
Talking about you. Yeah, we want to talk about you.
How you
got
some sports
film
and shit?
Yeah.
That shit made,
almost made me cry, man. That was like, oh. Yo, yeah, man. It is a sad day in life with the announcement of Magic Johnson contracting the virus for AIDS. And he retired today. Fellas, what do you think about that? I'm going to pass the mic over to my man, Futura.
This might sound strange, but I actually feel that it might be, it's obviously not a good thing for Magic, but I think it's a good thing for society, for somebody that's sort of that much in the public eye to be very, you know, positive about the way he makes it known and comes right out and says it. And, you know, he said he's going to work with the NBA and get on that, like, you know, HIV awareness. I think it's great. I think it's very sad, obviously, but it's great.
Bittersweet.
Safe sex, right?
Yeah.
What you got there, Rick?
Well said.